I never knew anything about, I knew there was a camp here, run by the RAF. There was none of this here then. All I know was like missing Hudson. That's all. Yeah.
It's funny because a lot of people outside it, I mean, I certainly didn't know there was a radio station before I came to this area, and I don't think many people in the area, unless they knew somebody worked on it, and even then the people who worked on it weren't allowed to talk about their work. So it was very hush-hush, I mean, you know, and it was, in those days particularly, it was just kept like
that. I think it was closed down when I was born.
Right, yeah.
just remember it all.
Yeah,
to be honest, I didn't know a lot about it. In that, you know, there wasn't much written down about it. There was the odd bit. I mean, obviously, it was in the local paper. When I first started working in here in 1967, it had closed, and people would still talk about it, but then people would still talk about the war quite a lot, because that had only been, you know, 20 years before. And you've got a lot of people in Shoreham who... quite a lot of Canadian people still living in Shoreham who've been in the Canadian forces and married local, women. So you had that area. And of course, it only just, national service had just finished, so you'd still got people who'd just come out of the army, who'd done their year or two's national service. So there were quite a people, you know, there was that atmosphere. But, the Truly Hill, we used to walk up there when I was at school. You knew it was a radar station and that, but I wasn't really aware of how many people had been there, because I think because it was, well, it wasn't exactly secret. I think it was not something that was publicised. I think they probably kept it out of the papers quite a lot, so I didn't really know much about it until the... But over the years, people who used to come in and say, have you got anything on the old radar station? No, there's nothing in any of the books, really. All the books we had, there wasn't very much, and people would sit and look at the old newspapers. There wasn't much to be said. Until one day, and it was about 3-4 years ago, Roy Taylor came in and said, have you got anything on them? And I said, well, no, there isn't anything. And he's told me, he said, well, that made my mind up. Oh, I'm going to write something, because he knew quite a lot already. He was in touch with quite a lot of people he'd been in the forces with. So he's written the two books, and he's written one book about his experience as a national serviceman, and secondly about the history of the radar station.
That gentleman was speaking about this area here being the old RAF camp. That was the first time I got into trouble with the police when I was away with a youngster. It was shortly after they'd started moving some of the families out.
Yeah.
A lot of them were empty. And they used to have a youth club at the top of Kingston Lane.
Yeah.
Where reprobates like me used to go to waste our time. A few of the windows had already been broken around here. So like a fall, I thought, well, we'd add to the broken windows. Not knowing at the time that there was an old telephone box. Right on the corner there.
Oh, yeah, remember.
With one of the local bobbies standing in it. watching me and my then friends. We heard him yell out, as coppers did in those days, "Oi, you lot!" We just left it, you see. But he was quicker than one of us, me. He caught me. He took me back to mum and dad's, who gave me a severe telling off, and then he went to visit the other three guys, because they were known to coppers in those days where people lived. Unlike today, you very rarely see them, but we all got away with a slap on the wrist.
I was walking up Stony Lane with him one morning, and there was suddenly blast breaking, and I've never seen a big, heavy man run so fast.
Moved.
But he got him.
Yes,
we always used to call him Mr. Plom, because he used to walk like this.
Yeah, it could well have been him. He was the old style copper. He used to walk with his feet pointing out like that. You used to be scared of him.
I think he's still alive, actually.
Oh, I don't know.
My son-in-law says, we were talking about it the other day, he said he thinks he's still alive. Mm.